Hello children, good morning. Welcome you all in Standard 10. Before starting the class, I would like to congratulate each one of you for your great success. Dear children, I know all of you were eagerly awaiting for your offline classes. But due to the present pandemic situation, we have to move for our online classes and teaching and learning through videos. Dear children, this situation is for time being. Very soon, we are able to teach you face to face standing in front of you in the classroom. Children, in the chapter Chemical Reactions and Equations, today I will deal with the chemical reactions. Here are few examples of chemical reactions which you can see in your everyday life. For example, combustion. Combustion of fuel. Either you can go for combustion of wood, combustion of petrol, diesel, combustion of LPG gas. Whatever be the type of burning, that is a chemical change where carbon turns to carbon dioxide. Rusting. Rusting of iron, again, is a chemical reaction. Digestion of food in our stomach. Photosynthesis. During the photosynthesis, plants take carbon dioxide, in presence of carbon dioxide and water and sunlight, prepare the food. That is also a chemical reaction. Other than that, working of battery, fermentation, washing hand. Washing hand means here, the soap. What soap we are using, the soap formation, that is a chemical change. Baking. During the baking, when we bake cake, breads, etc., some chemical reaction takes place. So you can observe all the chemicals reaction around you. Most of the reactions are chemical reactions. Some more examples of chemical reactions under that. You can see the first reaction, burning of magnesium ribbon. Children, you can see when we burn the magnesium ribbon burns with white dazzling flame to produce magnesium oxide. So, conversion of magnesium to magnesium oxide is a chemical reaction. Next is heating of calcium carbonate. When we heat the calcium carbonate, upon heating, it decomposes to form calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. And when we pass the carbon dioxide gas, does form through lime water. The lime water turns milky. So here, burning of or heating of calcium carbonate is a chemical change. Again, reaction of carbon dioxide with lime water is again a chemical change. That means here we can say this is a chemical reaction. Next example is reaction of iron nails with copper sulfate solution. Children, when we drop iron nail in an aqueous solution of copper sulfate, the color of copper sulfate turns or changes from blue to green. And at the same time, you can see the dark gray iron nail turns from dark gray or black to brown in color. So again, here you can see the changes that takes place is a type of chemical reaction. Now next, as just now I told you, all the combustion reactions are a chemical change. So when you burn the wood, it is a chemical change. But at the same time, when you cut the wood, cutting of wood, it is a physical change. So during a physical change, no new substances form, whereas during a chemical change, new substances with new properties form. So finally, we can define a chemical reaction. Chemical reaction is a process during which one or more substances undergo a chemical change with the absorption or release of energy so as to form one or more new substances. So that means during a chemical reaction, the substances change from one form to another form with the formation of new substances. You have already seen few example. Some more example: magnesium plus oxygen to form magnesium oxide, wax. Wax, which is a compound of carbon and hydrogen, on burning produces water and carbon dioxide. So burning of wax, children, it is a chemical change, whereas heating of wax, when you heat the wax, it turns from solid form to liquid form. That be a physical change. Iron combine with oxygen in presence of water to form hydrated ferric oxide, which already you have seen as a rust. It is a chemical change. Last example, hydrogen chemically react with oxygen. That means when we heat hydrogen, hydrogen burns, combine with oxygen to form water, which is a chemical change. That's all for today, children. Thank you.